Hello everybody and welcome to another tutorial of Industrial Shields. In this video, we will explain how to do the basic of working with digital GPIOs in our PLC. We will also do a small example to check if we are working correctly with the digital GPIOs. So, let's get started. Digital inputs are widely used to control sensors that only give us two values. Thanks to them, for example, we can know if a door is closed, if a deposit has the maximum value, or if a person is walking in a certain place. Industrial shears controllers are designed to work with digital inputs from 7 volts to 24 volts. It means you can use a lot of sensors directly to the PLC without adapting the voltage. Anyway, all the PLCs have two 5 volts compatible inputs that come directly from the Arduino. With both inputs, we can work with low voltage sensors. Several inputs have also optocoupler isolations, which will be useful to connect our PLC external systems. Before working with the digital inputs, pay attention to the switches. There are some features that disable some inputs, so check the input switches and check if the inputs are correctly configured. In order to work with the digital GPIOs, we must go to the Arduino ID and while we are programming, use the function digitalRead with the name of the desired input. For example, if we want to know the state of A04 input, we must put digitalRead A0_4. Keep in mind we cannot do that with pin 3 and pin 2 GPIO, because they come directly from the Arduino. To work with them, first you will need to program the GPIO as an input. The name of these inputs are 2 and 3. Now it's time to do a small example with the digital inputs. We will connect 3 switches to a 24 volts power supply, 12 volts power supply, and 5 volts power supply. We have connected the 24 button to A02. We have also connected this power supply ground to the A02 ground point. The 12 volts will be connected to the A010. This power supply must be connected to the PLC ground. Finally, we will connect the 5 volt power supply to the pin 2. In this case, we also must connect the ground at the same ground as the PLC. We will also connect a pull down to the pin 2, because we must be sure the system can receive a correct signal. Remember to check the input switches and be sure you have configured the inputs correctly. Once in the Arduino ID, we will open a new sketch. In the setup, we will configure the serial to debug the program. Also, we will configure the pin 2, because this pin is controlled directly from the Arduino. In the loop, we will make 3 ifs, which every input will want to know. If some input is on, a message will appear with the name of the input. In this tutorial, we have seen how to work with digital inputs in the Industrial Shields PLCs. Remember, you will find more information about our PLC in our blog or YouTube channel. Don't forget to follow us on Twitter, Facebook and LinkedIn to keep in touch. And I hope you enjoy this tutorial and see you in the next video.